Hello and welcome to the latest episode of the MPP Insider, your source for all the latest news in the marijuana policy reform movement. I'm Mike Mino. We're going to take a look at some stories we're following this week in marijuana in the news. We're going to bring you the latest installment of Marijuana by the Numbers, and we're also going to take another look at a political roundup. First up, marijuana in the news. One of the major stories we're following right now is in California, where there was a series of DEA raids on medical marijuana collectives in San Diego and Mendocino counties that seems to have violated the Obama administration's pledge to not intervene in state medical marijuana laws. According to all local accounts, the sites that were raided were complying with California state law. There was even a sheriff in Mendocino County who was quoted saying just that. But regardless, these DEA agents came in. They raided the collectives, they seized marijuana, they seized cash, they seized private property, and the DEA has yet to explain their actions that seem to violate this pledge made in October that the federal government would not intervene in state medical marijuana laws. And that brings us to our second story today, which is about the nomination of Michele Leonhart, who is currently the acting chief of the DEA and has been nominated by President Obama to take that post full-time. It's a post she also held under the Bush administration. This is someone who's a holdover and who has been in command of the DEA during times of raids like these, but also during the Bush administration, she oversaw dozens of raids on medical marijuana collectives. This week, MPP and our allies are calling on President Obama to withdraw Leonhart's nomination. She is a major problem for efforts to advance medical marijuana laws and even enforce federal policies that Obama himself has given approval to. She has also played a large role in blocking research done to move marijuana through the FDA approval process, so stay tuned for more on that. We're also following a story out of Colorado last week where a group of local veterans and our ally, Sensible Colorado, filed a petition with the state health department that would add PTSD to the list of qualifying conditions for that state's medical marijuana law. Currently, New Mexico is the only medical marijuana state that includes PTSD in its list of qualifying conditions, even though there's been a growing amount of research showing that medical marijuana can help relieve the symptoms of PTSD, something that affects nearly 20% of veterans returning from Iraq and Afghanistan. So that's going to do it for in the news. Next up, marijuana by the numbers. This week's number is 6. That's the number of medical marijuana dispensaries the state of Maine recently licensed for operation there, after passing an MPP drafted initiative that added dispensaries to the state's medical marijuana law. Also, New Mexico recently added 6 more dispensaries to its state's law. They currently had 5 before, so now they're bringing their total to 11 dispensaries. And these are positive signs. This is about increasing patient access. You know, for many patients, dispensaries provide the most convenient method of obtaining their medicine. And that also brings us to our third segment, political roundup. Another state that might see dispensaries soon is Oregon. After a ballot initiative to add dispensaries to that state's medical marijuana law, just qualified for the ballot. So come November, voters in Oregon are going to be able to vote on whether or not they add dispensaries to the state's medical marijuana law. This is just one more election we get to look forward to, November 2nd. Of course, we're going to see Arizona and South Dakota both vote on medical marijuana laws, potentially bringing the number of effective medical marijuana laws nationwide to 16. There's also an initiative in Detroit that would make possession of marijuana legal for adults 21 and older. And of course, the thing everyone's talking about, all eyes are on California this November, where Proposition 19 would make it legal, would finally end marijuana prohibition in California, would make it legal for adults to possess and grow certain amounts of marijuana. So, you know, stay tuned. If you're in those states, please come out to vote. Do anything you can to support. This is a really crucial year. Stay tuned for November and to future episodes of the MPP Insider and our blog. Once again, I'm Mike Mino. Thank you for watching.